Publix. The topic is Spellbound and Early Childhood Education, and we're talking to the author, Ms. Mary Williams. And of course, Ms. Williams, let's give you an opportunity during the last 6 minutes that we have here to talk about how Spellbound might be applied to the system, to the public school system, because I think that it's a very, very important book, and I think that you've got a lot of things in there that is sort of deceptive in terms of the very, very small nature of the book, and so let's talk about how that might be applied in the system as a whole.
Okay. Well, I think that really, I'm hoping that the system will use Spellbound and more or less see that it's placed in all the libraries mm-hmm. in the schools to make sure there's one in each library. Mm-hmm. But there's a process that we have to go through mm-hmm. to get that done. Mm-hmm. Then I'm thinking in terms of the reading teacher, something that has transpired this year. Mm-hmm. Now, I was a reading specialist years ago, and mm-hmm. they had the reading specialist pull those children out with the reading problems mm-hmm. and brought them up to par mm-hmm. through the Title I program. Mm-hmm. Now we have it back in the system. And I'm hoping that they can use this book mm-hmm. within the reading classes. Mm-hmm. For instance, I know the seventh graders, if you did not make a certain stay nine on mm-hmm. the sixth grade test, they have to take reading.
Good. Mm-hmm.
So they could use Spellbound as mm-hmm. a book to mm-hmm. more or less use to enhance the children along with the phonetic skills that Good. They're going mm-hmm. to talk. It's designed, you have main idea, you have details, mm-hmm. you have sequence, you have comparison and contrast. Mm-hmm. All the skills are employed there. Mm-hmm. Of course, vocabulary. Mm-hmm. So the teacher could use this particular book mm-hmm. and take in one story at a time mm-hmm. and digest it. Plus you have paragraph structure, mm-hmm. you know, you have, every skill is employed mm-hmm. within mm-hmm. this particular mm-hmm. book. So I'm hoping that this can be incorporated in the system mm-hmm. in that nature. Plus, and in the classrooms, it can be used as an enrichment.
Good. Mm-hmm.
You know, you always have books on your shelf. Mm-hmm. And then the children can pull the book down mm-hmm. or read it or get up and dramatize a story. Mm-hmm. Or they can read it within a little group, a little reading group, mm-hmm. and get up and tell what the story is about. So it can be used in many ways. Mm-hmm. So I'm hoping that this book can be used. Mm-hmm. I think we don't have enough books that mm-hmm. involve the type of information Good. That I have employed in Spellbound. Mm-hmm. You might find one book, mm-hmm. you know, individual story, but Spellbound has 11 stories.
Stories, very good.
11 mm-hmm. stories.
Important stories, too. Important very, very good stories, too.
Uh-huh. Yeah, very, very mm-hmm. good
short,
story.
Short, short.
Right,
and, yeah,
right.
Good.
And mm-hmm. a moral.
Mm-hmm.
There's
very
an
good.
Excellent moral
very
at the
good.
End of every story. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The teachers, the children learn how to trust their inner voices.
Good.
They
mm-hmm.
learn how to have faith and hope.
Mm-hmm.
And all of this is incorporated within the writing of Spellbound.
You know, I think, Ms. Williams, when you talk about faith and hope and all of those things that are imparted by this book, I think the only thing we can say is that this is indeed something that is needed in the education system today. Not only is
Thank
it needed
you.
In the early childhood education, but it's also needed in the upper classes and in some
right.
collegiate situations here, because a lot of folks don't believe, don't have the kind of faith that
right.
you're talking about. And let me simply say this and give you an opportunity to perhaps respond to this, but it seems to me that for such a small book, that a lot of thought went into this book, and I would imagine that this is a lifetime work on your part. I mean, which is to say that this is an accumulation of all of your knowledge and information, because you've already demonstrated by some of the things that you've said in
right.
reference to this book. What about
mm-hmm.
that?
Well, it is when we think of the drama that I participated in and started in fifth mm-hmm. grade, such as Creation
mm-hmm.
and all those,
good.
You know,
mm-hmm.
dramatizing
Very
it and
good.
Went all the way through high school and mm-hmm. participating in all kinds of contests mm-hmm. and winning. And then for a while, I had a drama and dance group at Aiken, and we traveled all over Metro
mm-hmm.
with that and dramatizing different mm-hmm. stories. And mm-hmm. then, of course, I'd always write my own information mm-hmm. or materials that I needed.
Mm-hmm.
So. So when I sit down to place it in stories,
mm-hmm.
late at night is when I get on the computer,
mm-hmm.
when everything is quiet.
Mm-hmm. Well, let me say, before we end the show for today, If an individual would like to, and I know you're trying to get it into the school system, but what if an individual would like to have a copy of this book? Are they offered in the library? I mean,
yes.
The stores are, talk
right.
about it.
Right. Yes, you can find Spellbound at Alcabaland on John Merritt Boulevard.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, the author has some copies of it,
mm-hmm.
and we're working on getting them Davis Kid
Good.
And also Borders.
Okay.
I have had a book signing that was given to me and given for me,
mm-hmm.
and I guess I was just overwhelmed with people all mm-hmm. over Nashville. Articles have been in, I mm-hmm. guess, in the newspaper three
good.
Or four
mm-hmm.
times. There was a large article in Tribune and mm-hmm. also in the Pride.
Very good.
Relating to Spellbound. I'm doing something in Lebanon,
mm-hmm.
a book signing up there.
Very good.
So of course the sororities there, Alpha Kappa Alpha and Phi Delta Kappa,
mm-hmm.
and they have just been overwhelmingly
mm-hmm.
cooperated and happened to get this book across.
Very good. And of course, Ms. Williams, over the last 25 seconds we have here, let me thank you for coming
okay.
by and giving us that excellent information about a topic that ordinarily we don't think about, and that's about
mm-hmm.
Our children.
Right.
And I think you understand that we've had many problems in trying to convince folks to deal with children, 3 and 4 year old children. But let me thank you for bringing that information, and let me encourage our audience to tune in again next week for another informative edition of Comments. Thank you and good morning.